Please see the first part of this lecture for better understanding. This is the continuation of the first part of this lecture. So, which of the following is a drug considered as a potassium sparing diuretic? By this question, what you will get understanding means, the class question of the pharmacognosy and pharmacology is very important. You will get a direct bit from this. See, in this question, four options is given: triamterene, chlorothiazide, mannitol, and furosemide. These three are other than the potassium sparing diuretics. One is thiazide, one is osmosis diuretic, and another one is furosemide, which is a loop diuretic. So the answer is first one. Increasing number of the normal mycosis may be present in the following tissue except. See, increasing number of normal mitosis may be present in the following tissue except you have to see here exception. Some questions they will give in the exception form. So here, bone marrow cells, they increase the number of normal mitosis. Hepatocytes, nothing but liver cells, they also show the increasing the mitosis cells. And intestinal cells, nothing but GIT, gastric general GIT, they also shows the increasing number of the mitosis. But the nails, the adult cells, they does not show the increasing number of the normal mitosis. To which chemical class the vinca alkaloid belongs to? See, if you know the class question, you can directly write the indole. An antibiotic that resembles the 3' end of the charged tRNA molecules. This is also a direct bit. If you know the concept, then you can write the pyromycin. If the coercive force is seen between similar molecules are less than the adhesive forces between the similar molecule, a deviation in Raoult's law is observed. Here, which derivation will be seen? So, this complete question says this statement only. This coercive force means that the same molecules bind with some force, and A and B indicate different molecules are binding. If the adhesive force is greater than the coercive force, then it automatically shows the negative deviation. For this, you have to know the Raoult's law, positive and negative deviations along with examples. This is also an important bit in the view of GPAT orientation. Phenylalanine, precursor of the most of the phenolics in higher plant, is a product of which one of the following pathways? If you see this, you have to know the pathways. Sigmic acid pathway, mevalonic acid pathway, methyl erythronic pathway. These three are the generally presented pathways. And malonic acid pathway, there is, I think as per my knowledge goes, there is no malonic acid pathway. Malonic acid is there, but there is no pathway, I think so. Sigmic acid pathway shows useful in the synthesis of the aromatic amino acids. And mevalonic acid and methyl erythronic pathway, these two are useful in the isoprenoids synthesis. And remember, in this bit they given methyl erythrol pathway, but the real name is methyl erythrol phosphate pathway. They are useful for the isoprenoid synthesis. See, which of the reagent forms the given can be used to protect ketone group? See, when molecule or a structure contains more than one functional group, it oftenly goes for the reacting with both functional groups. So you have to protect one functional group for the for promoting the specific reaction. For that, if you want to mask the ketone group, you have to treat with the acid methanol. It temporarily masks the ketone group. If you do the hydrolysis, again the ketone group will come again. For the amine group, you have to mask with ditertiary butyl dicarbonate. Remember, in this bit, two bits will become acidic methanol for the ketone group masking, ditertiary butyl dicarbonate for the ammonium masking. Which of the following drug causes less inhibition of the REM sleep? If you know the sleep cycle, then only you will get the answer for this bit. So by this bit, what you can know, sleep cycle also very very important, and in sleep cycle many events are going on that you have to know, and which drug will show the effect on which phase and how much it will be showing that effect. That also very very important. Now the starting material for the synthesis of sulfamethoxazine are, by this bit what you will get, the drug synthesis is very very important, and they will give direct bits. For the starting material, what you have to know, the synthesis you have to know. Name of reactions and synthesis are very very important in the MC. For this question, sulfamethoxazine R, answer is B. The clinical trial registration in India is maintained by General Indian Council of Medical Research is in New Delhi. They will maintain the clinical trials and their guidelines, regulations they will follow. And the regulations are present in Schedule Y. Remember, clinical trial schedule, clinical trial guidelines are present in Schedule Y. And match natural products with their chemical nature. See, if Cognosy, this type of pit is compulsory for the GPAT. You have to know the source as well as the chemicals. Chemical, it will be, what will it will be produced. If you know the origin as well as the chemical, then only you will go, you can solve this kind of pits. See, what is the correct order for the unsaturation present in the following fatty acids? See, as the these are the fatty acids. As the number of carbons increases, the unsaturation also increases. Palmitoic acid contains 16 carbons only. Arachidonic acid contains 20 carbons. These both two have no doubt. Fourth one has the more unsaturation, and the palmitoic acid has the least preference. But the main difference is linolenic and linoleic acid. Both are seems to be same, but the difference is only one N is came in between them. For if these kind of bits, how we have to remember them, so you have to keep on code. For this I will say one example. Compared to these two, this term is very big letter. Big letter has the more unsaturation, so this will get the more preference. Like that, sometimes you have to keep some codes which may not have a logic, but it will remember for the long term. So linolenic has more unsaturation compared to linoleic acid. So preference order is 4-2-3-1. Which of the following is not a component of evaporator? See, heat exchanger is a component of evaporator, vacuum separation component, condensator and cyclone separator. These two you may get confusion. Condensator is used in manufacturing. Why means? Generally, solvents which are used in the synthesis of some drugs are very very costly. When you are getting evaporation, that will get in a pure form. If you, that you do the condensation, you will use for the second time also. For the purpose, they are using condensation. But cyclone separator is a particle size separator where there is no application in the evaporation process. So unit operations also very very important. You have to focus on the unit operations. For engineering topic, pharmaceutical engineering, that is also important topic. You have to see the instruments along with parts and uses. In Parkinson's disease, there is a predominant loss of the dopaminergic neurons, primarily in C. The concentration of the dopamines are more in the substantia nigra, whereas the concentration of noradrenaline is present in the locus coeruleus. These two are important. These two are not that much important. So it indicates that you have to be very specific with the every part of our body so that you can give these kind of answers. At equilibrium, the receptor occupation is related to drug concentration by. See, in these four, the first one says nothing but acid-base reaction, so it is not correct answer. Leinweaver's Brook equation says about the concentration of the substrate. This is also not the related one. And Langmuir's adsorption isotherm. And this one will give the correct answer. So what it indicates, the theories you have to know. By that you can get answers directly. See, this is not a logical question, this is a direct question. If you know the theory, you can rightly easily apply. Which method is not suitable to calculate area under the curve? See, least square method. Trapezoid rule is used to measure the number of trapezoids in a unit area. Weighing and plotometry. See, plotometry is nothing but measuring of the area of a flat surfaces. Graph generally observed in a platform. X and Y axis only. So this is and weighing. See, the curved area of paper will be cutted and the weight of the paper directly proportional to the area. So by that way, this is also correct one. Integration curve. If you are a math student, you will easily say that area can be determined by using integration curves. So the right, the not suitable for the curve area detection is least square method. By this, you can best fit of the graph can be measured, but least area we cannot measure. See, you are getting the second question related to the clinical trials. So by this you can get to understand that how much importance of a clinical trial. The clinical trial is being conducted with 1500 volunteers, which may be the spontaneous period. See, phase 1 2200 members, phase 2 100 to 400 members, phase 3 300 to 3000 members, phase 4 greater than the 1000 peoples. This will generate criteria. If you want clear this type of bits, you have to thorough with the clinical trials. The right answer is phase 3. Which of the following drug has not undergone a clinical trial for its use to decrease the intracranial pressure? See, we are not using clinical trial. Thought bit from the clinical trials. See how much important it is. Clinical trials, they are generally not performing clinical trials. See, among these four, acetazolamide is a diuretic and laterally proved as a intracranial pressure decreaser. So already its efficiency and toxicity studies already completed. That's why no need of performing clinical trials. But for the efficiency, for the incranial pressure may randomly tested for some people. That's it. There is no clinical trials like other chemicals. That's why this is an example for acetazolamide, which does not perform the clinical trials. Colloidal dispersion have which type of rheology? See, they are not mentioned either the hydrophilic or the lipophilic colloidal dispersion. So this question is non-specific. The answer must be non-specific, non-neutronous flow. If they given the any specific colloidal, then we'll go for the diluent or the pseudoplastic. If they are not given specific, we have to go for the non-specific only. That is important here. And which of the four nitrogen group arteries individual is more basic? For basic, you have to have the unpaired electrons. Generally, it is already paired. That's already substituted with the hydrogen. So this is the more basic, simple one it is. If you know the basics of the chemistry, you can write. What will be the product of the given reaction? See, another Raymond reaction is came here. If you know the Raymond reaction, then only you can go through this. So Raymond reaction and a second bit is came. Toluene is converted to which compound? Toluene is converted to which compound in presence of CrO3 with acidic anhydrous? Remember, this is an oxidizing agent. If toluene reacted with oxidizing agent, it produces first benzyl aldehyde. Whereas, in presence of acidic anhydrase, there is no conversion of the benzoic acid. If acidic anhydrase is absent, then it will convert it into benzoic acid. So now, because of presence of acidic anhydrase, benzyl aldehyde is the end product. Thank you. If you want any topic, please suggest in comment. Please subscribe my channel, like, share to your friends also.